Hey guys, welcome back to an exciting tutorial of Creating Process. In this tutorial, we'll look at how you can remove face from any photo image and add a hollow effect to it. We'll be working on Photoshop to create this concept for the cover. To create this, we'll first mask out the face area from the image, then add a nice drop shadow with a soft edge. After that, add a pattern with a low opacity in the background and give a nice gradient overlay. And lastly, do some color adjustments using the adjustment layer. We'll also add some water drops. So let's begin with the tutorial. For this tutorial, I'm going to use this photograph. You can download this image using the link in the description. So open it in Photoshop. Here, double click to unlock the layer. Now the first thing we're going to do is to mask out the face region. So press P to activate the pan tool and draw a path covering the inner face region. Then using the direct selection tool, edge the anchor points to maintain the shape of the path. Edge the handles to maintain the flow. Once you are done with the adjustments, go to stroke and remove the color. Now with the command or control pressed, click on the thumbnail of the path layer to make a selection. Then select the image layer and click on mask option to mask out the selection. To reverse the masking region, use the keyboard shortcut Command or Control I. Next, add a new layer for the background and arrange it to back. Fill it up with white color. Now, we'll be working on the hair details. As you can see over here, the hair region has been masked out. So create a duplicate of the image layer and select the layer mask thumbnail. Then using the eraser tool with a black foreground color, erase out the mask region with a smaller brush size. To see the masking in silhouette view, click on the thumbnail of the layer mask with the Alt pressed. Here, you can choose the soft brush, reduce the spacing to work in much more details. Erase out the masking for the other side as well. Now to give more softness to the edges, double click on the layer mask thumbnail. This will open up the properties panel. Click on mask edge, then set the feather to 3.2 pixel and click OK. Lastly, give some final touch up. Next, we'll add texture to the background. So double click on the layer to open the layer start panel, apply pattern overlay, choose a nice pattern and scale up the size. Now, to add drop shadow effect, double click on the first image layer and activate drop shadow under the layer start panel. Set the angle to 127 degrees, increase the opacity to 80%, distance to 218 pixel, spread to 29%, size to 142 pixel and click OK. Let's change the background pattern to this and scale up the size. Also, reduce the opacity to 13%. After this, we'll also add gradient overlay color. Change the gradient color to red and green, set the blend mode to overlay and scale the size to 21%. This will give us this nice pattern in the depth. Next, to add a drop shadow of the hair on the inner surface, click on the thumbnail of the first image layer and using the eraser tool, erase out some portion on the left side. After that, click on thumbnail with the Alt press to get back to our original view. Next, we'll do some color adjustments. So create another copy of the image layer, then add a layer adjustment layer. Here, adjust the sliders to add contrast. After that, map it to the top image layer. Next, add human saturation adjustment layer. Set it to colorize. Edit the saturation value to 21 and the hue value to 32. Now add a curve adjustment layer. Here, edit the curves to control the darkness and the lightness in the image. Next, we'll add some water drops to the inner background. So add a new layer. Then using the circular selection tool, make a small circle. Fill it up with white color. Use the shortcut Alt Backspace. After that, reduce the fill value to 0%. Then double click to open the layer start panel. Here, add inner shadow, set a distance to 7 and size to 21 pixel. Also apply inner glow and drop shadow. Under inner glow, attributes, set the opacity to 51%, source to center, size to 79 pixel, and under drop shadows, set the size to 6 pixel, distance to 9 pixel, and click OK. This will give us this nice drop shadow effect. To check out the in-depth tutorial on realistic water drop design, check out the link in the description. So to add few more water drops, select the brush tool, choose hard brush, edit the brush size, and click. This way, add few more water drops with variation in size. The drop seems very light, so let's increase the inner shadow opacity and distance. After this, to add a glossy effect, draw a oval using the ellipse tool, fill it up with white color, then make a selection using the circular selection tool and apply mask. Inverse the masking using the shortcut Command or Control I, rotate the angle and place it over here. Do the same for the others as well, create a duplicate of it and add it to all the drops. Next, type out the text. Change the color to black, use the font Arabic Bold Italic. Now apply pattern overlay under layer star panel. We'll give this a wood-like texture and scale up the size to 81%. After that, change the layer mode to overlay. And we got this nice text with pattern. Scale up the size and do the proper placement and adjust the spacing between the alphabets. Next, to add a more depth to the hollow space, add a new layer just above the drops layer. Choose a black color using the color picker panel. Choose soft brush and start drawing along the left edge of the face. Reduce the fill value to around 71% and give a Gaussian blur with a radius around 45 pixel. Add little more shades on the forehead region as well and reduce the overall fill value to 51%. Next, we'll add some shadows along the outer edge. So add a new layer and click on the thumbnail of the layer mask to make the selection. Then place the layer on top. Change the layer mode to overlay and apply color using the soft brush tool. To get a proper effect, let's place it just below the curve adjustment layer. This will set the color tone as per the document. Lastly, type out a text to add title to the cover. Scale up the size, give TWCENMT condensed regular font. We have used the combination of white and blue color. After this, you can do the final touch-up and edit each and every details. Finally, we have completed creating a conceptual photo cover design using Photoshop. We have seen how you can remove face from any photo image and add a hollow effect to it. We have used some new tools and techniques to create this design. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.